Good morning, good afternoon, and good evening to all the participant who is staying in a different part of the world. So as our today's topic is, which is our fifth session, is a para table tennis. So here we are just going to have a discussion with that. And now I just want to give some brief of the guidelines for the dear participants, that before when you are going to join meeting, please start your video and mute yourself first thing. Then second, as the presentation start, you have to listen the presentation, and after when presentation completed, you will get the time to ask your question and doubt with our speakers. And after that, we will going to have a open forum for discussion of any topic that you want to discuss after the question round. Then we will move to conclusion, and then we will disclose our next topic of session, which will going to held on next Sunday. So here I'm just sharing a screen with you. Yes. Thank you, dear participant, for unmuting yourself and starting your video. Yes, sir. So here today we are having our speaker with us, Mr. Akon Michael Roy from Chennai, Tamil Nadu, India. He is a table tennis. And he is international table tennis, para table tennis player, wheelchair class 5, and Tamil Nadu Para Table Tennis Promotion Association's General Secretary and Founder. He done his graduation in Social Initiative and Management at CSIM, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. His vision is to provide multiple platforms for para table tennis in India to excel and portray their talent. And his mission, create innovative and motivate the face of para table tennis in India. So please clap for Mr. Akon Michael Roy, Chennai, Tamil Nadu. And here I'm, here Michael, floor for you and deliver your presentation.
Thank you.
Michael.
Okay, sir. Ready? Thanks for the wonderful opportunity. I am Michael Royce, international para athlete from Tamil Nadu and general secretary of Tamil Nadu Para Table Tennis Promotion Association. I got to know about the para sports only in 2003, started with discus throw, javelin throw, shot put, badminton, and moved to table tennis. The reason why I kept changing my games was internal politics. In simple words, life is like a football game. While we are running after a goal, a big crowd is chasing us to block our goal. Sometimes it happens to be a same set goals too. Though I was a national medalist, I was unable to participate in internationals due to financial problems. My never give up attitude helped me to sustain in this para sports. If you look at the history of para table tennis, the table tennis was invented in Great Britain in 1880s. Paralympic Games was first approved by the International Paralympic Committee in 1984. while the International Paralympic Committee was formed in 1989. Understand?
Yeah, we can hear you, Michael.
Sir?
We can hear you, no problem.
Para table tennis is an adaptation of table tennis for athletes with a range of disability. The sports follow the rules set by the ITTTF, International Para Table Tennis Federation, with some modification for wheelchair players. The athletes are classified according to their disability in disability. Classes from class 1 to 11, para table tennis matches include 5 set of 7 points each and are usually played in a best of 5 format. The sports was included at the Summer Paralympic in 1960 in Rome, and since the compelled regular league. The first world championship of the sports were held in 1990 in Netherlands, then in 1998, and then after organized in every 4 years. Para athletes, 65 countries. Indian para athletes are many international classifications. Players are also here, like Bhavina Patel, Kunal Arrow, Raj Aravindan, Arokya Michael Royce, Dinesh Babu, and in Bangalore, Sanjeev Hariji, and Delhi in Sonu Gupta, Trivendra Singh, many more. So, rules of para TT players, squaring and games, legal serving equipment basics. Minimum criteria for TT players. Impaired muscles power. Athletes impaired massive range of movements. Hypertonia, limb definitions, accident, leg length difference, short stature, intellectual impairment. Categories of para TT players. There are 11 classes grouped as wheelchair TT 1 to 5, standing TT 6 to 10, and intellectual impairment 11. Okay, presentation now continued by Mr. Sanjay Akshay. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael Roy, sir, for a lovely presentation. And he's covered a lot of basic details of para table tennis. And now the rest part of the presentation is going to be presented by Mr. Sanjay Achir. And he is our second speaker. So I just want to give a brief introduction of Mr. Sanjay Shri Krishna Achir. He is from Latur, Maharashtra, India. He is a passionate, truly passionate for table tennis player. And he is a para table tennis classifier by ITTF and TTFI. And table tennis coach certified ITTF level 3. He is a level 3 ITTF coach. And para table tennis player class 10 international. And manage various tournaments at a state level. He has an experience of more than 10 years in this table tennis promotional fields, activities. He is regularly involved in it since 10 years. And he has done diploma in mechanical engineering and electrical engineering. And he also work on presently as a Spandan oxygen production project, Akshay Sanjeevani Scheme. So now,
We need to pin Sanjay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, I can. Gee, I'm afraid to go on as 32. Yes, I can. Take a look.
This is an inspirational video. All of you are like it. I hope so.
Hello. Haan, sir.
Hello. How are you, sir?
Yes.
अभी सर अभी Zoom meeting में हूँ सर. Zoom meeting attend करके फिर phone करता हूँ.
Continue.
अभी घंटा चलेगी सर घंटा. हाँ हाँ.
आप लोगों ने अभी जो वीडियो देखा वो एकदम काफी इंस्पिरेशनल था. आप लोगों के शरीर पे रोमांच खड़े हुए होंगे, रोंगटे खड़े हो गए होंगे. तो ये जो किमया है हर गेम में, हर इसमें करने की, वो डिसेबल लोग ही कर सकते हैं. मगर जनरली दीज पीपल्स आर कैटेगरीज ऑन हिज फिजिकल कंडीशन इनटू टू टाइप्स. दैट इज, वन इज एबल and another is disabled. And you doesn't believe that these disabled people are doing like this. It is not easy for the common people or the common person to achieve like these goals and just like these performances. In Hindi, they are called as Viklang, disabled persons. But our Prime Minister PM Modi has given a new word for that Viklang is Divyang. It is replaced by this new word is Divyang. So I am very thankful to our PM Narendra Modi ji. Before some days ago, they are called as differentially able. So nowadays, para players known as Divyang players, where the God has given them a divine body. So they are the Divyang players. When we talk about the sports, there is a competition. And in the competition, it should be fair. It should be fair competition in the players for with the opponent. And in competition, somebody loses, somebody wins. But for the fair competition in the para, they are certified in the various categories. One player having in the different categories in the different games. If any player having his category T10 in table tennis, he doesn't have the same category in running, in athlete, in other other games too. It is just before my partner is talking about the table tennis categories, that is from 1 to 10. The 1 to 5 is for the wheelchairs and 6 to 10 for the standing categories. And 11 category is the special category for the intellectual lagging people. Then who is going to categorize these new players? And here is the role starts for the classifier. IPC, International Paralympic Committee, and ITTF, that is the governing body of the para table tennis and all table tennis. So what is the role of the classifier? It is to define who is eligible to compete in the para sports and thus the opportunity to reach the goal of becoming a Paralympic athlete. So this is the key role and he played in this process for this fair competition. There are two types of classifier. One is the medical classifier and another is the technical classifier. Some doctors, physicians or physiotherapists may get medical classifier, and in technical classifiers, sports scientists or physical educational TT players who are having, and the TT coach who are having the experience, they can get a classification course and they can have as a classifier. There are three levels of classifier, that is a level 1, level 2 and level 3. Level 1 classifier is only participates in the nationals and he can classify the players, but there is a teamwork. The three numbers of classifier are there while the classification. One is the national level classifier, then another is the international level 2 or level 3 classifier is there. One is from medical classifier and two others are the technical classifiers who check the new players. For the first level, first only at the national level classification where the events are organized by the NPC, National Paralympic Committee or the National TT Federation is done. Then level 2 classifier is become a part of international classifier, but he cannot, he is only the participants with class 3 classifier. And the level 3 classifier is act as a chief classifier in the international tournament. All those classifiers have minimum 3 years experience in the each level. There are two more levels in the classification. The first is the junior lecturer and another is the senior lecturer. When you have passed the level 3 classifier, then you can become a junior lecturer and then you can become a senior lecturer. In India, only one classification level 1 course was conducted by TTFI at Sai Gandhinagar in 2015. And in that classification program, only 10 numbers of classifiers will be attended from the all over India, that classification course. We have only major one more classifier, you know, from level 3 is Dr. Ajay G.V. He is a very senior player. He is from Varanasi. He is MD Artho and specialization in AMCO. He is a level 3 classifier, only one in India. And he is international classifier too. Second classifier is Mr. Vinayak Sutar from Kolhapur. He is an entrepreneur. फिलहाल वो सॉफ्टवेयर में काम करते हैं एंड द लास्ट ईयर ही हैज डन द लेवल 2 क्लासिफिकेशन एंड माई सेल्फ इज अ लेवल 1 क्लासिफायर. जब भी ये पैरा के नेशनल्स होते हैं वो नेशनल्स में हम तीनों का एक कमिटी होता है, वो कमिटी के साथ हम क्लासिफिकेशन करते हैं अंडर ऑब्जर्वेशन. और ऑफिशियल हमने अभी तक 3 टूर्नामेंट्स में TTFI के अंडर नेशनल लेवल के इस पे क्लासिफिकेशन किया है, जिसमें अजय सर एज अ मेन चीफ क्लासिफायर रहते हैं एज अ मेडिकल, और टेक्निकल में विनायक सुतार और मैं दोनों हम काम करते हैं. फर्स्ट टूर्नामेंट में हमने नियर अबाउट 55 न्यू प्लेयर्स को क्लासिफाई किया था. फिर सेकंड टूर्नामेंट में हमने नियर अबाउट 72 प्लेयर्स को क्लासिफाई किया, और अभी जस्ट ये अप्रैल में जो हुआ वो टाइम पे हमने नियर अबाउट 80 न्यू प्लेयर्स को क्लासिफिकेशन किया है. एंड न्यू क्लासिफिकेशन इज डन बिफोर द 2 डेज ऑफ प्रायर योर टूर्नामेंट. एंड द प्रोसेस ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन इज जस्ट लाइक दिस. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी कलेक्ट द एप्लीकेशंस फ्रॉम द न्यू पैरा प्लेयर्स एंड द डॉक्यूमेंट्स टेकन फ्रॉम द न्यू पैरा प्लेयर्स द एथलीट्स. देन इट विल बी एक्रेडिटेशन एंड आइडेंटिफिकेशन ऑफ द डॉक्यूमेंट्स इज वेरीफाइड फ्रॉम आवर साइड. देन दैट इज फॉर द इज पर्सनल आईडी एंड मेडिकल सर्टिफिकेट्स विल बी चेक. देन द फिजिकल असेसमेंट इज डन by medical classifier. At the time of classification, new players should be only in attire of the playing tournament with the same dress and having his shoes in his legs. After doing the physical assessment by chief classifier who is having the medical classifier, the technical classifier took the charge of that classification, and on ground it will be taken a test of that new player. That is the technical assessment to check and assess this functional abilities of that new player. The functional abilities, it depends upon the 3 S and 3 C's are there. The 3 S is, one is a spot, the second is the speed, and third is the spin. One spot is the length of the ball is short, wide, or on the body. Speed is the slow, fast, and moderate. And spin is the top spin, back spin, and side spin. And the 3 C's are the control, consistency, and changing the game. We observe all these things with playing with this new player. And after that, we had a discussion with the team. All team, and then after the discussion, we finalize the classification class of that new athlete. When we have a doubt about his classification, then we will take him in under observation, and while he is playing in the tournament, then we will observe, and then at the last time, we will finalize his classification in which category he will play. It is based on the impairment and the activities of the athlete. Yeah, it divides into 10 categories, but only one category, that is the eye impairment category, is not involved in Para-TT2. The first category is the impair of muscular power, then impair of passive range of motion, then limb deficiency, then leg length difference, then short stature, hypertonia, then ataxia, then atrophies, and intellectual impairment. These are 10 are the eligible impairment for the classification, and there are few points for the non-eligible impairment, that is the pain in your body, that is the impairment, and then the hearing impairment is there. The low muscle tone is there. Is just like this the impairments in the eligible criteria area. So this is the all over about the classification process, which is done by the classifiers, and it is very key role of the classifier to classify the new players and to which class he will be playing. At the last, I would like to say thank you to Mr. Ajay sir, for Ping Pong Club president, then Mr. Lokesh Bargi, who helped me for this presentation, then my partner from Chennai, Michael, then MSTTA for recommendation my name for the classification training program, then TTFI and SAI and MPTTA for classification training program at ITTTF arrange किया है उन्होंने, और अभय प्रशाल से मैं जयेश आचार्य जी और हमारे पैरा टीटी इसके प्रेसिडेंट ओम सोनी और सेक्रेटरी प्रमोद गांगरडे, उनका भी मैं यहाँ पे थैंक यू बोलना चाहूंगा कि वो पैरा टीटी के लिए बहुत अच्छा प्रमोट करते हैं और आगे भी करते रहेंगे। और हमारे ग्रुप में जो 10 वीक के मिस्टर मोहन कुमार है, उनको भी मैं थैंक यू बोलना चाहूंगा, क्योंकि अनिल कुंबले का ये जो कंपनी है वो इसमें ज्यादा पार्टिसिपेट्स करता है और दे आर टेकिंग इंटरेस्ट इन पैरा टीटी एंड दे आर आल्सो अरेंजिंग द अंडर टीटीएफआई द लेवल आईटीटीएफ कोच लेवल 1, 2 and 3 बाय देम एंड ऑल ओवर इंडिया फ्रॉम लास्ट 2015। एंड एट लास्ट आई वुड लाइक टू थैंक्स माय ऑल पैरा फ्रेंड्स हु आर जॉइनिंग दिस मीटिंग एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स हु आर लिसनिंग my lecture on the classification of para TTI players. Thank you.
Sanjay, we received two questions. I will ask two questions we have already received for you, so please stay here. Now I'm coming to Mr. Vijay Kumar. He actually wants to say something to the audience.
Okay.
Yeah, Vijay Kumar ji.
Yes.
Vijay Kumar ji, no. We'll come to Poonam Rani to listen to her. You know what she wants to say. Poonam Rani.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. आप कुछ कहना चाहते हो जो?
First of all, thanks so much कि आपने ये मौका दिया कि हम सबको एक प्लेटफॉर्म पे अभी मीटिंग के लिए बुलाया, ताकि सब अपनी अपनी बात कह सकें और हमें कुछ और जानने का मौका मिले। और बस थैंक यू।
कोई आपका सवाल है, कुछ आपका क्वेश्चन है हमारे स्पीकर से या किसी ऑडियंस के लिए जो?
नहीं, अभी तो नहीं है सर।
ओके, अभी रमेश जी ने अपना हाथ उठाया है। रमेश जी, रमेश, यू वांट टू से समथिंग?
यस सर।
या
सर, मेरा सिंगल क्वेश्चन है रिगार्डिंग क्लासिफिकेशन के। एज सेड बाय संजय सर, एवरीथिंग इज ओके, बट समटाइम जब मैं देखता हूँ व्हाइल प्लेइंग एट द स्टेडियम और एनी हॉल, इन सेम क्लास आई फाइंड दैट द वन पर्सन इज एबल टू मूव बेटर देन मी एंड अनदर वन इज यू नो अनएबल टू मूव, बट क्लास इज द सेम फॉर बोथ द प्लेयर्स। सो ऐसा क्या रीजन होता है, या कोई क्लासिफिकेशन का रूल है, या क्या है? मीन्स किसी भी एक क्लास में अगर बात करूं मैं, एक पर्सन अच्छी तरह मूव कर रहा है, भाग रहा है, सर्विस कर रहा है, स्पीड खेल रहा है, दूसरा पर्सन उसके अपोनेंट है, बट वो उसका मोमेंट बहुत कम है, वो उतना नहीं मूव कर पाता उसके अकॉर्डिंग, तो ये कोई रूल है या क्या है, मतलब दोनों का क्लासिफिकेशन जो होता है, ये मेरा सवाल है।
तो संजय जी से आप चाहते हैं कि संजय जी इसका जवाब दें?
यस सर।
ओके
जी। ओके रमेश जी, आप जो बात करते हैं उसमें जवाब ऐसा है कि जो प्लेयर खेलते हैं उनकी मेडिकल टेस्ट जो होती है उसमें क्या क्या इम्प्यूरिटीज है वो मेडिकल टेस्ट में लिखे वाला रहता है, तो जो उनको मेडिकल ग्राउंड पे उनको चेक किया जाता है मेडिकल क्लासिफायर से, उन्होंने वो नोट किया रहता है। आपको ऐसा लगता है कि वो मेरे से ज्यादा मूवमेंट करता है वो, तो वो उसने एबिलिटी डेवलप की हुई रहती है। यू कैन ऑल्सो डेवलप योर एबिलिटी टू मूव or something else, and there are the abilities what we have decided. हम कैसा उसको डिसाइड करते हैं, तो अपर लिम स्टैंडिंग जो लोग रहते हैं उनको अपर और लोअर लिम और बैक, ये तीन क्राइटेरिया उनके रहते हैं। अभी स्लाइड्स नहीं है, नहीं तो मैं वो स्लाइड्स बताने वाला था, स्लाइड्स मूव नहीं हो रहे इसके लिए, तो वो स्लाइड्स में क्लियर बताया है कि एबिलिटीज में क्या हम देखते हैं, जो सिटिंग प्लेयर है उनके लिए भी व्हील चेयर में क्या मिनिमम एबिलिटीज रहना चाहिए, तो वो वजह से उनको ऐसे वैसे अलग अलग क्लास में हम डिफ्रेंशिएट करते हैं। तो हमारी कोशिश तो यही रहती है कि सेम प्लेयर की कैटेगरी हो और सेम उसमें कॉम्पिटिशन सही हो।
ये मैंने चेक किया, जैसे क्लास सिक्स की बात करूं जो नेशनल हुआ था, इसमें एक हमारा प्लेयर अशोक पाल, और अनदर पर्सन जैसे अंशुल गर्ग गया, को एक बंदा नया आया यूपी के से, तो उन दोनों में देखते हो तो बड़ा डिफरेंस लगता है मुझे दोनों का मोमेंट में।
नहीं ऐसा नहीं रहता है।
अच्छा,
सिटिंग कैटेगरी में भी उनके मिनिमम डिसेबिलिटीज और क्राइटेरिया फाइनल है, मैं आपको बताता हूँ आपके लिए सिटिंग में होना, तो मेरे पास सभी उसके ये है।
मैं स्टैंडिंग प्लेयर हूँ, तो
the athlete is not able to walk without support, okay, then to step sideways functionally it is not possible, and then single above the knee amputation with the stump length not longer than its 1/3, unless there are exceptional medical circumstances, and above knee amputation in one leg with below knee amputation is there. This is minimum criteria for the sitting players. Okay. And for the class 4, class 5, there are the different stages. That is, the physical criteria is one of the there. Then technical criteria, whether he got the speed and spot. And third is the his physical criteria for the movements. On which the class is classified by the classifier.
And dear audience, we are joined by Biken Thapa. Biken Thapa is a ITTF promoter last 4 years. And let's hear, you know, from Biken. He wants to give a message to us. Yeah, Biken.
I'm from Nepal. I come from the eastern, okay, which is close to, if you understand, which is close to West Bengal on the eastern part and Bihar on the southern part. So I belong to Biratnagar, and I am a ITTF level 2 certified coach. I've been lucky to do ITTF plus PTT level 1 also, and I did a different course under Christian Lillerus. Most of you, I'm sure you know him. I was lucky enough to do para TT level 1 course, which is completely designed and completely dedicated for para TT players. It doesn't have ITTF portion in it. And I am also like our previous speaker sir, he said, I'm also a national level 1 PTT classifier. Okay, I did that in Bhutan recently, 2019 I did, before COVID-19 struck. And to the question, I want to say something to the gentleman who previously asked. No, he said that in the same category, one is a better player and one is not so good, not working. I have an answer to that also. Then the answer for that is simply because there is range in each class. There is range. Okay, they say I'll give you an example, like. We start from the
spinal cord.
When you have a spinal cord injury,
yeah.
You start from the cervical, the neck area, then thoracic, then lumbar, then we go to sacral, you know, that monkey bone area. So most of the cases, what happens is there's a slight difference, not much. In those cases, what happens is in every class, it is like, I'm sure, sir, Sanjay, sir, I think, classifier, national classifier, sir, he told. He has done national classifier. I'm sure he knows that it has been taught in every classification course that there is a range in all class, in all the classes. Yeah. So that is why a player can be good. Suppose there's a player in class 4 that is mildly disabled, wheelchair mildly disabled. If he's in class 4, he can be a better player in class 4, and another can be a little less better player, but they both can fit in the same category. So I think it is very important that we understand that, that there is range in all the classes. Range. So that is one reason. And another thing also, I would like to tell you all that I have I was the head coach of the ITTF para TT program that was a 3-year pilot project in Nepal. If you all know that Nepal was severely affected by the Maoist and the insurgency, then during that time we had many casualties, you know, injuries from the security forces and the Maoist forces. We had several injured people from the security personnel. And then in 2015, if you remember, we had a massive earthquake. And it was the reason that, you know, ITT considered us among like 90 countries. It was a pilot project regarding that. I was the head coach of the eastern part of. So I did that ITTF PTT coaching course. That was a joint venture between the ITTF, the Korean government, United Nations, UN, Korean government, Nepal government, and the ITTF. So I was lucky. And I have been able to, you know, I was lucky enough to work with so many PTT players. I have national champion in my standing PTT class category. He's my champion. You know, working with all these, what I want to say is, these people are really special. You know, I've worked them for three. So we don't call them disabled. We call them differently abled or
differently
specially able. They are very special. They are very special. Yeah. You know, when I worked with them, it was very interesting. You know, there were like 16, 17 of them, and nature wise they were very different. Okay, someone was very, you know, well behaved. Someone were very short tempered, and people with low maturity, psychological maturity. You know, it was very hard dealing with most of them. Those who had low psychological maturity. If I say something, you know, they would get upset. Or if their friend is doing well and they are not, so they would, you know, kind of throw at me. They would say that I'm not paying attention to them. So it was a very challenging part of working with this. But over the period of time, what I learned is not only I was teaching them, I was learning a lot from them. And fortunately, Nepal has been doing very good in international also, in the international events also. One of my students, you know, 4-time national champion, he won a bronze medal in Korea. It was in 2018. He became third. The foundation has been, you know, the Paralympic Committee of Nepal, they have been working very nice. And I can say the same, I don't know much about India, but the same thing I can say about Bhutan also. They are also in the regional level. I think they are also doing a fantastic job. I was there in 2019 during Diwali time. It was Diwali time. I couldn't attend Diwali 2019, just before the outbreak pandemic. So yes, it's been very nice to hear from the experts who were here. And I just wanted to, you know, share a few of my experiences working with these wonderful athletes.
We'll again come back to you again, because we have one specific question again from you. In the meantime, I'll come to Vijay Kumarji, because he has been trying to say something. Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Poonam. So nice. I have recollect my memories with Para by joining your meeting.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
thank you.
But one small query we have, that we don't know you. We don't have your introduction. So we are new.
Oh, myself,
sir,
is
Agrawal, sir, is from Sai. And now he is retired, but he is having more and more experience for para TT players.
So he can be our best liaison person. He is from Sports Authority of India.
Yeah.
Oh, very nice. Then I have got two things more to discuss with you.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. Any message you want to give us? You are from Sports Authority of India.
There are lot of things to do with para table tennis. Not para table tennis, actually. lot of things we are lacking in para sector. And because I belong to table tennis, so I am more concerned about the table tennis. There are so many things I have discussed with Sanjay also. My opinion will be there that every state there should be a state level competitions should be started.
Yes.
And that competition can be organized only with the force of players only, because at present I have also conducted to know about the para table tennis and to know the para table tennis players in India. I have conducted some coaching camps at Gandhinagar while I was in job. After reaching Gandhinagar in 2013, I have conducted para camps. I have started, and now Gandhinagar has been declared the
para center
for all over India. This is the only para center declared by Government of India and Sports Authority of India. Due to corona, some development is not up to the mark, but definitely it is going to be construct very soon. And in that, the good thing is that para table tennis players are going to get a separate table tennis hall especially for para.
Oh, very nice.
That was already planned. If all plans are getting approved as per proposed by me, so our all para table tennis players will be getting a table tennis hall with at least six to eight tables, especially for para players.
But how will you source the chairs? From where you will source the chairs?
Pardon?
For example, if the player who is into wheel, the one who is playing with the wheelchair, so there are specification for the wheelchair also?
Dekhe, competition is going to be organized, and competition are getting organized only same table.
No, I mean wheelchair. Wheelchair will be same.
Wheelchair players, it is depend on what type of table competition has taking place. So, what type of table? So, normal table competitions are there. So, training also will be on wheelchair players also will get training on the same type of tables.
So basically, you have submitted a proposal to government, which is under consideration. Your proposal
already proposal was prepared by me and sent our we have sent the proposal for 5 sports to start with the 5 disciplines, that is table tennis, badminton, athletic, swimming, and powerlifting.
Over all five,
and all the 5 games, this center has been approved. And lastly, last development was that center was declared, this center, first we have given a proposal for 5 disciplines. Now later, in final stage, this center was declared para center. Actually, once para center will start, normal player activity may be stopped at this center.
It will be special para center.
That possibility also there. And we are having a another plot for this proposal was under progress. I don't know whether it is prepared or not. Now I am not that because of corona, not going to SAI office also. So we have to organize the international conferences and this on para, we have given another proposal to start with some 200 bed hostel and two big hall with all facilities.
hostel facility will be
medical facilities and all.
Okay, now I'll come to Jagan Mukherjee.
He is the first para player that I have actually known in Delhi. So let's hear from Jagan. Yeah, Jagan ji.
Hello sir, thank you so much sir.
Welcome, welcome.
Thank you sir.
Yeah.
बहुत ही अच्छा प्लेटफॉर्म है सर, आप लोग अरेंज किया सर इसको. I thank you so much sir.
आप कुछ मैसेज आप देना चाहते हैं, कुछ कहना चाहते हैं आप जो?
नहीं सर, ऐसा कुछ नहीं सर, थैंक यू सो मच.
ओके, मेरा एक छोटा सा सवाल है आपसे.
बोले सर.
कि जब आप मान लीजिए मेरे अगेंस्ट अगर आप खेलते हैं, मेरे ओपोनेंट में खेलते हैं, तो हमें आपको स्टार्ट लीड पॉइंट्स देने चाहिए या नहीं देने चाहिए जो है?
मतलब समझा नहीं सर, अगर मैं नॉर्मल के साथ खेलता हूँ सर.
हाँ, यस यस यस. नहीं देना चाहिए. उसमें हमने 0-0 से ही स्टार्ट किया था.
हाँ, 0 से.
तो क्या वो हमारा मिस्टेक था या सही है?
नहीं नहीं, सही था सर, सही था.
नहीं सर, ओके. जब डिसेबल प्लेयर नॉर्मल प्लेयर के साथ जब खेलना चाहता है तो ऑल रूल्स आर सेम.
Okay. Same, sir. Yeah, became in
para TT,
then the wheelchair rules apply. Wheelchair rules apply then.
Yeah.
But wheelchair is playing with a normal body, the rules of the wheelchair play comes into operation.
But speciality about Jagan is he plays with one hand. He's a standing he's a player.
Class 10 player.
No, no, I'm talking about wheelchair only.
Okay.
Wheelchair.
Okay. Right.
If he is a wheelchair player, the rules for the wheelchair player applies.
Right.
Yeah.
If he's playing against a normal player.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Okay. We'll come to.
Thank you. Thank you, Ajay sir. Thank you.
What about the table, Ajay sir? And one more thing about the table. I think the PTT table is slightly different. You know, the legs are little 25 to 30 centimeters.
No, sir. No, sir. No, sir. Tables are same.
Slightly.
Same tables.
There is no difference.
We have stacked. We have stack tables. We were given stack tables, which was a little inside. Yes. Stack tables, and there was the logo, wheelchair logo.
There is no specific कि भाई legs कितनी अंदर होंगी या कितनी बाहर होंगी. Is specifications are there for the top only.
No sir, I think आप लोग को एक बार देखना चाहिए. वो stack has they produce. Different tables, slight, and they are which I have got here in my training center. So, uska leg thoda andar rehta hai, sir, because you know that we for the wheelchair players.
Yeah, he's right.
For the wheelchair. Yeah.
Okay.
Can, and it has
for the wheelchair.
Yes.
And it has a wheelchair logo also imprinted.
Right.
On the side of the table.
Yes. So this.
That produces it.
Yeah, this is one thing that you know could actually be encouraging for us, that we also need to have similar tables which are useful for para players. Very good point.
Yes.
Yeah. I'll come to our friend Trivendra. Yeah, Trivendra wanted to actually say something. Yeah, Trivendra.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you wanted to say share your. We asked you to share your experience. You know what all you have gone through in table tennis.
हाँ सर, मैंने अपना जो टेबल टेनिस स्टार्ट किया था 2010 से स्टार्ट किया था, और जो मैं मतलब कहने ते हुए अच्छा नहीं लगता, लेकिन ये रियलिटी है कि इंडिया में अभी पैरा टेबल टेनिस उस हिसाब से अभी स्टार्ट नहीं हुआ जिस हिसाब से हमने सोचा था. अभी कह सकते हैं कि स्टिल इट इज बिगिनिंग स्टेज इन इंडिया, और डेवलपमेंट जिस हिसाब से होना चाहिए था इंडिया, क्योंकि इतना बड़ा वाइड कंट्री है और इतने प्लेयर्स हैं यहाँ पर खेलने वाले, लेकिन फिर भी उनको उस हिसाब से एक्सपोजर नहीं मिल रहा है. और ये फर्स्ट टाइम है हमारे इंडिया में कि फर्स्ट प्लेयर है जो क्वालिफाई हुआ है ओलंपिक के लिए, भाविना पटेल फ्रॉम गुजरात. तो मोर देन 100 प्लेयर हैं इंडिया के अंदर जो भी इंटरनेशनल में खेल रहे हैं, लेकिन फिर भी सिर्फ एक ही प्लेयर है जो क्वालिफाई कर पाया है, वो भी सिर्फ अपने एफर्ट से और अपनी मेहनत से. उसमें ना ही TTFI का इतना कोई सपोर्ट था, ना ही साई का कोई सपोर्ट था, और ना ही किसी स्पोर्ट अथॉरिटी का कोई सपोर्ट था.
I believe so. The connections we have given you for Australia table tennis. So if
we talk to them, we invite them, or they invite us for a you know joint promotion. You know, I will not call it a promotion, but as an event, a sports event in para category. Then, for example, today we learned that you know the table is altogether different. So maybe we can learn from Australians also, because they have a very good federation for para table tennis.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. जैसे आपने टोल्ड किया कि ऑस्ट्रेलिया अब यही डिफेंस देखिए सर, ऑस्ट्रेलिया टीम ऑलरेडी सिलेक्टेड द कॉमनवेल्थ गेम्स देयर टीम फॉर पैरा टीम्स और मोर देन लास्ट फोर और फाइव ईयर दे आर प्रिपेयर ट्रेनिंग फॉर देम बट वी आर स्टिल इन इंडिया वी डोंट नो हु विल बी सिलेक्टेड फॉर द कॉमनवेल्थ टीम.
That is okay. See, one is there are two platforms. One is government platform, which is TTFI or SAI, and one is private platform. So if we invite them in capacity of private platform, so there is no harm.
Yeah, there is no harm, sir.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Sanjeev Hajri from Bangalore. I think he is busy.
Sir, no.
Okay. You want to say something, Sanjeev?
हाँ sir.
Yeah.
कुछ नहीं अभी तो right platform में चल रहा है शायद मेरे हिसाब से. अभी last year हमने last March में हमने एक national conduct किया था PTTPA के under. अब उस हिसाब से अभी शायद platform पे आ रहा है. अगर एक हमें Paralympics में एक medal आ गया तो हमारी पूरी life बन जाएगी, para table tennis की life बन जाएगी इंडिया में. और जहाँ तक मुझे लगता है कि प्रमोद सर और TTFI के लोग, बाकी सभी लोग हमारे ऊपर थोड़ा दया करके हमारा लॉन्ग टर्म डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम अच्छी तरह से वो सेटरेट करके साई में फाइल अप्लाई किया तो अच्छा रहेगा. ऐसा ही है सर, लास्ट में तो बहुत दिन से देख रहा हूँ हम कुछ भी करो कुछ भी फायदा नहीं हो रहा है. अभी प्रमोद सर देखेंगे क्या करेंगे आगे चल के. स्टेट टूर्नामेंट तो हमने ऑलरेडी कंडक्ट किया था सर लास्ट दिस ईयर सर. 35 प्लेयर्स आए थे कर्नाटका स्टेट में. बहुत ही अच्छी तरह से हो गया है हमारा स्टेट इवेंट कंडक्ट. फर्स्ट टाइम हुआ है इंडिया में स्टेट इवेंट. इसी हिसाब से हमने प्लान भी कर रहे हैं कि रीजनल इवेंट करवाए नवम्बर और दिसंबर में. जहाँ तक लग रहा है हमें नवंबर नहीं तो लास्ट में नहीं तो दिसंबर में हो जाएगा रीजनल इवेंट. ऐसे प्लान चल रहा है सर कर्नाटक से. बाकी सब देखेंगे सर क्या होगा आगे चल के. अच्छा हुए तो बहुत अच्छा है. सभी प्लेयर्स जूनियर्स प्लेयर्स ज्यादा आए थे इस बार नेशनल्स में. उस हिसाब से काम करना है सर आगे.
थैंक यू. एंड
सर मैं एक बात बताना चाहता हूँ कि अपने ग्रुप मेंबर ही है मिस्टर दिनेश बोल के जो बेंगलोर से है. वो काफी मेहनत कर रहे हैं पैरा टीटी के लिए. उनके पास काफी प्लेयर्स हैं और वही सब ज्यादा अरेंज कर रहे हैं. तो उसके लिए मैं उनको भी थैंक यू बोलना चाहूंगा दिनेश सर को.
सो विल कम टू रेडमी इफ दे वांट टू से समथिंग. मिस्टर रेडमी और मिस रेडमी. नो रविंद्र दत्ता प्रसाद वांट्स टू से समथिंग. दत्ता प्रसाद.
Hello?
दत्ता प्रसाद you want to say something?
Oh.
Okay,
Ajay sir.
Yeah.
I just need means a basic question for all the speakers as well as the dignity persons. Okay. So my basic question is means how we can increase the number of differentiable players at a grassroots level. This is my question, means how we can increase the strength of differentially abled player at a grassroots level, rural as well as urban area. First, I just want to answer this question from Beacon Thapa.
Okay, see, that's a very good question, I think. When I started, when I was given in the charge of the head coach of the Eastern Province for the PTT training, the pilot project, when we started, we were only four male and one female player. Altogether, we are only five players. And the ITTF, you know, they wanted us to cover more. And it is very challenging. Like, I stay in Biratnagar, so it is not possible, you know, to call other players from the adjoining cities. It's very tough for them. They have to, you know, again, they have to travel by public transport, which is obviously not, disabled friendly. So it was always challenging. So what we did is we
consulted the local disabled organizations. So we went there, and apart from that, we wrote letters to, you know, the schools, the PAPSN, we call it the school association, the private school associations, you know, we mailed them. Then they, you know, send those information to all their member schools. From there, we got names, and we went to, there was one organization who, in the local government body, our mayor's office. So I collected information from there, and I just went, I just told them what is this project all about, what is its ultimate aim, so what they can achieve from this. So it is very tough, you know, it is not like able-bodied. The percentage is always less, especially in a city like mine, which is not like Kathmandu. Kathmandu is a much bigger city. So I'm sure in India, you know, the big cities, the population is much very high. So in those places, I think you can get, but it is always a tough call, sir. It is a very tough call. And eventually, after 1 year, I was able to get 18 players in total. And most of them, you know, from wheelchair, and ultimately they became the national champions in the coming 2-3 years. They started from zero. They started from zero. Only Kathmandu, the center, had facilities. All the players, the great players, were from Kathmandu. We just started from zero. So it took us 2 to 3 years, you know, to excel. Okay. And then this is how it happens. So, yeah, so you have to work in tandem with, you know, the other bodies, you know, local bodies that deals with all these disabled people. So that's all I can say.
Beacon, I just want to know, do you have a concrete concrete table tennis table over there at your place?
No, we don't have. We don't use.
Okay.
I'll come to Prema. So, now, Prema okay, wants sir. To say something. Prema? Prema, can you hear us?
Yes, sir. I can hear you.
Yes. You want to say something? Yes.
No, as people have stated, like most of the women, especially, are not much comfortable getting into the sports. So if we have more motivation and people who can train. Actually, I'm from Tamil Nadu, one of the national players and wife of ROK Michael Royce. Okay, so even though I have my man here, even myself find it very difficult to, you know, join these gatherings, events, and with the family. So in such a background, to encourage more women to get into the sports will be better. That's why I wanted to be part of this, actually.
Thank you.
So traveling, everything becomes a challenge for us.
Right. Traveling is a big challenge, actually.
Correct. Mm. Traveling to Straight national up, yes. sports Straight mainly, up. You know, now it is happening in indoor. Mm. So we need to change to shift to 2 different trains. And, you know, both are wheelchair people. We need someone to help us. You know, that is also a problem.
Yeah, I believe Vijay Kumarji is listening all the conversation because he can actually understand the gravity of the situation. Correct. Wherein Michael Royce is a para player, Prema Royce is a para player, and then they have to, you know, travel into by flight or by train. Vijay Kumarji.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah,
no doubt, a big challenge all the para players are facing, especially in traveling.
Yes.
But when there is a question of becoming a player and facilities and all these things, with my all sports life, we can very well understand that to become a player, you need some different type of support from the pupil, from the organization, from the institution, and from the government also. To prepare a player, a group of pupil is required to for any level, even district level. You start with the district, you go to state, you go to national level. For every level, you need support. If I want to prepare a player, for district level, I have to search the player, especially para player. Then I have to start with motivation. Yes, I have to convince his or her parents that this, what are the benefits if you are sending your player for table tennis, and what are the future, everything. Player, once parents get convinced, then player's interest is most important. And third comes where to start. There should be a center in that particular city. Then we have to get the support. And para players के लिए मैं सीधा सीधा कह सकता हूँ कि टू स्टार्ट विद पैरा प्लेयर पैरा प्लेयर्स ऑल्सो हैज टू स्टार्ट देयर प्रैक्टिस सेशन विद नॉर्मल प्लेयर ओनली.
करेक्ट.
देयर कैन नॉट बी अ सेपरेट सेंटर फॉर पैरा एट डिस्ट्रिक्ट और स्टेट लेवल. इट कैन हैव
नेशनल लेवल.
या नेशनल लेवल वी कैन विद डिफिकल्टी. दैट ऑल्सो वेरी so much work we have done to start a para center at Gandhinagar. We got the sanction, but till date it is not functional. I got retired even 2013. We have started work to start with para center immediate after coming over in Gandhinagar. I started working on para, and we have started then. Before my coming, some athletics camps were conducted at Gandhinagar, 1 or 2, 3. But after that, we have conducted camps in all the disciplines: swimming, athletics, badminton, table tennis, and powerlifting. All the disciplines. But state level, I will advise all the para players to have their practice session with normal players.
Normal
players only, without. Keeping anything mind that they may face difficulty when they say session. If you are not playing under center in charge, so you may face difficulty that player may not give you time to practice with you. But that difficulty, that difficulty we are facing.
I believe Vijay ji, Jagan is at the advantage because he is playing with the normal player mostly. So that is why, you know, his game becomes more better.
Definitely. You have to practice with normal player only. My advice is all the players, you don't even dream to have a separate center for where only para player should get practice.
And Poonam is playing with the normal player or with the para player itself?
Yes, sir. With normal players, I play.
Okay, so you are also playing with the normal player.
Yeah.
Right.
No. In India, I believe all players will be regular practice, daily practice. All will be doing with normal players only, and at that center, because it is अभी हमारे पास इतने ज़्यादा पैरा प्लेयर ही नहीं है कि हर जिले में एक पैरा के लिए अलग सेंटर हो सके. अभी तो स्टेट वाइज हो जाए बहुत बड़ी बात है.
बट सर, लेट मी गिव यू अ वेरी शॉर्ट एग्जांपल दैट यस्टरडे देयर वाज अ यूट्यूब मीटिंग ऑफ दिव्या चितले एंड स्वास्तिका घोष यस्टरडे इवनिंग, एंड 21 ऑडियंस वर देयर इन दैट मीटिंग, एंड टुडे विद द पैरा वी आर ऑलरेडी 21 ऑलरेडी.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
I'm
yeah.
giving you a simple, you know, simple realistic that, you know, the people are interested, para players want to play, but this the challenge that they have is to reach, you know, to reach to the correct arena where they have the arena.
So the biggest thing, see, for every whatever you either study or sports, both the qualities are, you need a exam for that. The basic problem why players in India, so many players may be starting table tennis, but at the same time so may be leaving also, because there is no examination. I mean, there is no district level or state level competitions.
Yes.
अगर इफ वी कैन स्टार्ट डिस्ट्रिक्ट और स्टेट लेवल कंपटीशन वी शुड एनकरेज द वी शुड आस्क द पैरा प्लेयर ऑफ देयर ओन डिस्ट्रिक्ट दे शुड रिक्वेस्ट द नॉर्मल एसोसिएशन दैट इन when they are conducting district championship for normal table tennis they can have a event for para player.
Yeah, Lokesh will agree that
this is the same topic that we discussed 3 weeks back, that along with the normal tournaments one day can be kept for para player.
Yeah that is the only possible way to regularize the player in the competition. Years together you are practicing table tennis and there is no competition in between, then what you will do, tell me.
Okay,
what is the player's opinion?
Yes, I want you to see this. You can see this. This is the table I'm talking about, stack centerfold. I was talking about this one.
Stack,
so this is slightly different from the ones that you get. Yes, this is specially, and you have that wheelchair logo in it. So this is a special kind of table produced by Stag, which I use in my PT training center. This is what I was talking about.
Right.
So the slightly the legs are inside.
And I'll come to Sandeep. He has been silent for a long time. Sandeep, you want to say something? Sandeep? No. Bhavika? Bhavika wants to say something? No. Hemant?
No, sir. Money is the biggest point for any sport, and especially for the para. We need more sponsors so that we can have more tournaments to promote the para players. As I have two players playing with me, Trivinder Singh and Ramesh. So the only problem with them is when they travel, they have to pay for themselves because they have to travel by air, as we guys were discussing. And the second problem with them is there's no special permissions for them. As I have friends, I have my batchmates who has joined audit or some other central services. They have been given special permission by the government to practice. So they get debate of 4 to 5 hours to go and practice more. But these are specially able players. They don't get any time, special time from the government. So we need some good people. To actually support us, be it be bureaucrats or be it be private players. And talking about people who say that we actually do support table tennis, but they when it comes to para, they don't. So we need to push some big players of our table tennis industry only so that they support our para players.
I believe today our finding is Vijay Kumar ji again and again. Actually, I'm coming to him because he has retired from Sports Authority of India. He knows the subject. So if we give our problems in written to Vijay Kumar ji, then I think it can reach to the correct authorities.
No, money. My experience in 30 years of service and after service. In money is a problem and money is not a problem. It is either side. When we are doing our job and we are planning to do something, money is available in every center. India is such a big country for proper. But money, there are people, those are deceiving the players as well as normal people for false organization are going to be made and collecting the money, and then some fraud are taking place and this and that. So it is up to our convincing level. If we are preparing a proper programming, I can give my example like Gulbarga, Karnataka. There is a place Gulbarga. which is not at all known for any sports. And Karnataka Sports Department was having I got my posting there. And I have started with one room, table tennis. I started there. And I have one team was prepared for that within 3 years, which won the bronze medal in Dasara Festival within 3 years of job. So, organization, you have we, some our program, our organized program, if we are doing and conducting, then money, I don't think it will become a problem in India, any part of India.
Sandeep has joined us again. He wants to say something. Sandeep?
Hello. Good evening, sir.
Yeah, good evening.
सर मैं आपको ये बताना चाहता हूँ, जैसे थापा सर ने बताया कि मैं खुद व्हीलचेयर प्लेयर हूँ क्लास वन कैटेगरी का, तो जैसे थापा सर ने बताया कि जो व्हीलचेयर एसेसिबल टेबल होते हैं वो अलग होते हैं, और वो इवन मेरे को पूरे हरियाणा में मेरे को कहीं से मिला भी नहीं है।
स्टैग से मिल जाएगा ना, स्टैग उन्होंने बताया।
सर मैंने यहाँ पे काफी जगह डिस्कस किया पर मेरे को ये अवेलेबल नहीं हो पाया।
नहीं, स्टैग बिकन हैज ऑलरेडी, मतलब इन्होंने बता दिया स्टैग मैन्युफैक्चर कर रहा है जो।
अच्छा, ओके।
नहीं नहीं संजीव, आई वुड लाइक
बिफोर वी गॉट दोस टेबल्स फॉर डोनेशंस, सर लेट मी बिफोर वी गॉट दिस सेंटरफोल्ड टेबल्स फॉर फ्रॉम डोनेशन फ्रॉम स्टैग, वी आल्सो यूज द नॉर्मल टेबल्स, बट ड्यूरिंग द inauguration of the project, I think Vivek Kohli sir, you know, he was kind and generous enough to give away those tables in donation to Nepal. So Korean government also helped us with other equipment, braces, track suits and all, and tables. I think Vivek Kohli sir was kind enough to give us that. Yes, Stack does produce. Maybe you don't find it in your city, but yeah, if you consult the Stack.
No, I'll share Vivek Kohli contact details with Sandeep.
Sandeep,
yes.
हेलो संदीप।
यस सर, यस विजय सर।
संदीप, ये जो व्हीलचेयर की जो टेबल, व्हीलचेयर के लिए जो टेबल आप बात कर रहे हो ना, जो थापा साहब ने बताई है,
हाँ जी सर,
वो कोई स्पेसिफिकेशन नहीं है, पहले तो ये समझो।
सर एक बात मैं आपको बताता हूँ, हम जैसे मतलब जैसे नेट के पास कोई बॉल आ गई, हाँ, तो अगर हम उसको रिसीव करने के लिए जाएंगे तो हमारे घुटने, वो जो अगर नॉर्मल टेबल होती है उसके अड़ जाते हैं, टच करते हैं।
करेक्ट। मैंने भी ये चीज यहाँ पर जब कैंप कंडक्ट किए थे ये चीज करी थी, मगर मेरा कहने का मतलब ये है कि स्पेसिफिकेशन
मैं आपको बताता हूँ। इवन अब की बार जो नेशनल में था, एक टेबल था स्टार्टिंग में, टेबल नंबर वन, उसके नीचे वो स्पोर्टिंग वो जो व्हील्स और वो थे वो नहीं थे, उसमें मेरी व्हीलचेयर काफी अंदर तक जा रही थी, जिसके कारण मैं छोटी बॉल पिक कर पा रहा था।
एग्जैक्टली मैं बता रहा हूँ कि जो ये टूर्नामेंट के लिए स्टैग वाले जो टेबल बनाते हैं ना, बेचते हैं अपनी।
हाँ जी सर,
आपने देखा होगा कि सेंटर कोर्ट कई बार बनाते बेचते अलग अलग डिजाइनों में, और उसमें सिर्फ सेंटर का भी, सेंटर पोर्शन में ही लैग, चारों लेग नहीं होते, बीच में से एक वो बना देते हैं, और वो भी
यस सर,
हाँ, तो वो आपके लिए बहुत हेल्पफुल हो सकती है।
हाँ जी हाँ जी।
तो सेंटर को
एक और सर, जैसे अभी बात चल रही थी कि स्पॉन्सरशिप, जैसे हमारे नॉर्मल प्लेयर्स इवन स्टेट खेलने जाते हैं तो उनको डिस्ट्रिक्ट पे करती है,
तो दैट इज, ये तो मैं कह ही रहा हूँ,
नेशनल खेलने जाते हैं उनको स्टेट पे करती है।
Correct.
बट जो पैरा प्लेयर जो नेशनल खेलने फ्लाइट से ट्रेन से जाते हैं वो अपने पैसे से जाते हैं, इवन फूड अपना,
इवन काफी, अगर जो लड़के जो बच्चे, मुझे पता है ना, अभी त्रिवेंद्र बैठा है और इवन यहाँ पर भाविना वगैरह भी हैं, ये लोग इवन इंटरनेशनल टूर्नामेंट भी अपने पैसे से गए हैं।
विजय जी, इसमें संदीप, कैन आई से समथिंग जैसे जैसे स्वास्थ्य का घोष को विराट कोहली फाउंडेशन ने स्पॉन्सर किया हुआ है,
जी सर,
तो इसी तरह से अगर आप भी विराट कोहली फाउंडेशन को अप्रोच करें तो इसमें हर्ज क्या है, क्या हार्म क्या है उसमें?
सर मैंने काफी जगह ट्राई किया कि कहीं से मेरे को छोटा मोटा स्पॉन्सर मिल जाए ताकि मैं इंटरनेशनल खेल आऊं, तो यहाँ पे सभी जो भी इंटरनेशनल या स्पॉन्सरशिप के लिए आते हैं या हम किसी को रिज्यूम भेजते हैं तो वो चाहते हैं कि पहले हम अपनी आउटपुट उनको दें। अगर हमारे पास आउटपुट ही आ जाएगी तो हमें स्पॉन्सरशिप की जरूरत ही नहीं रहेगी। तो अगर आप स्पॉन्सरशिप वगैरह इशू करवा सकते हैं या कहीं से इस चीज का मैनेज हो जाए तो ये पैरा प्लेयर्स के लिए काफी बेनिफिशियल रहेगा।
I think that विराट कोहली फाउंडेशन कैन हेल्प इन माय ओपिनियन।
नहीं बारी साहब, अभी हम लोग जो नेशनल कंडक्ट हो रहे हैं ना हमारे,
यस सर ऑडिबल।
देखिए पैरा का जो नेशनल कंडक्ट होता है ना वो स्टेट वाइज इनविटेशन नहीं है, उनमें स्टेट वाइज इनविटेशन नहीं है और आपको स्टेट वाइज प्रमोशन के बिना पैरा प्लेयर्स का काम नहीं चलेगा। और स्टेट वाइज वो जो मैंने आप शुरू में ही बताया ना, अगर हमारी पैरा की जैसे नॉर्मल टेबल टेनिस चैंपियनशिप स्टेट की होती है उसमें अगर एक इवेंट पैरा का जुड़ जाएगा और पैरा टेबल टेनिस कि स्टेट चैंपियनशिप अगर हमारी रेगुलर हो गई जितने भी कैटेगरीज में हो पाए तो आपको पैरा के लिए स्पॉन्सर्ड मिलने भी आसान हो जाएंगे क्योंकि आपकी परफॉर्मेंस दिखाई देनी शुरू हो जाएगी स्टेट लेवल पे, आपका खिलाड़ियों का पैरा खिलाड़ियों का नाम पेपर में पब्लिश होना शुरू हो जाएगा, उस स्टेट की पब्लिक पैरा खिलाड़ियों के बारे में जानकारी मिलनी शुरू हो जाएगी और इस तरह से उसको प्रमोटर अगर चाहिए तो उसके लिए मैंने बताया ना एग्जाम का होना बहुत जरूरी है, हर लेवल पे कंपटीशन अगर होंगे तो उसी लेवल पे आपको प्रमोटर भी मिलने शुरू हो जाएंगे।
What sir is trying to say is inclusion. वो inclusion है sir. What you are saying is inclusion.
Inclusion. Yes.
PGT and able bodied. It has to be included.
Yes. That is what.
पहले it was segregation, then it was integration. Now it is all combined. It is inclusion. So that is very important point.
Right. Very important. So we'll come to Lokesh because we left him in between with the presentation. That video he was trying to, you know, because of the network we couldn't see that. So are you ready now, Lokesh? Are you ready now?
So presentation is almost the explanation is given by Michael sir and Sanjay sir, all the details. And I will share the PPT presentation with all the participants. And dear participants, I have sent a link in chat box. So just fill that form. So we will get your email ID. So we will further give you all the details regarding with that. And in next coming Sunday, we are going to have our discussion. Topic for discussion is rules and regulation of table tennis. In next Sunday, we will going to have a that is 20 of June. Our topic for discussion will be rules and regulation of table tennis sport.
Okay. Now, anyone wants to say something more? Anyone?
And
Ajay, sir.
One more request.
Yeah, Trivind. Yes, Bikin.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yeah. Sir, actually, I have my national team planning program. ITTF expert from Jordan is going to be online. Now,
okay.
Today is the last day. So I want to take take your leave.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you, sir.
Sir. Hello, sir. Hello. Sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Sanjeev.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm. Sir, PSIUS. Kya hai, sir? Sorry.
Lokesh is PSIUS. Where is Lokesh? Yeah, location.
Yeah,
actually, sir. Sir, actually, it's simple. As we are here, table tennis, because we are table tennis lover. So I start with the word ping pong Philip, which means table tennis lover. It is the first letter of P. P-S-I-U's first letter is ping pong Philip. Then next one is the starter, S for starter. Incubation, I for incubation, U for unique, and S for society. So we have a whole sentence, group of words, ping pong, Philip, starter, incubation, unique, society. So mainly it is deal with the promotional activity of table tennis sport at a grassroots level, which is our main motto, to increase the strength of table tennis sport, make table tennis sport universal, popular, inclusive, and creative. And in startup section, we motivate youth to start their own business idea or dream, to convert that dream into a successful entrepreneur or a business. In incubation, we provide them training regarding with that startup idea. And unique, we train them about for their unique talent, because every individual have their own talent with art, music, dance. Means overall, we focus on overall development of individual. In S, that is society section, we talk about or we awareness everyone about sport, environment, and education. That's the whole meaning of PSIUS, ping pong Philip, startup, incubation, unique, society.
Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Sir, one more thing. I have sent a WeTransfer link in that. WeTransfer. So I request all the participants to have their short video of your introduction and upload it on a WeTransfer. And I have also sent an email in that, so we will get your basic introduction of a video, short video.
Okay, now coming to my question to Sanjay, the two questions that I was asking. Sanjay, is it okay?
Sir, excuse me.
Sanjay? Okay.
Yes,
Sanjay. Sanjay, now can I ask my two questions?
Yes, sir. No problem.
Okay. Now, this a para player, can he apply, you know, online, or is it all manual forms that he has to fill, you know, to get into any?
He can fill online, sir.
So, what is the link for that? Is there any link to fill that to qualify for the para player category?
That is when the nationals are going on. The MPTTA gives the link for that event, national event.
Okay.
And
so
at that time, they are eligible to fill that form.
So presently, that I'm sure that due to COVID, presently the link is not available due to COVID. But
yeah,
next the link will come.
Huh.
Okay. And my second question is that to assess the classification 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So is it a committee which decides the classification, or is it one person?
Yes. No, sir. It is a committee.
Okay. How
there
many?
Is one.
Yeah. How many?
Three people, sir.
Three people
are there.
Okay.
One is from medical, and two are from the technical side.
And in Delhi, which committee is presently running that?
So, no, sir. Qualification उसके लिए national का tournament होना जरूरी है.
No, no.
जब national tournament होगा, जब ही classification होगा.
Then committee will be decided.
Yes.
No. Sir, there is no separate link currently for classification.
But Sanjay said that there will be a different link. He said that, you know, once the
no,
game.
No, no, sir. There is
when,
no.
When the national is organized by PTFI, then there will be a link.
जैसे विजय सर ने बोला कि अभी प्रॉब्लम यही है कि स्टेट वाइज कोई एसोसिएशन या कोई इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर अभी नहीं है, तो ये सबसे बड़ी प्रॉब्लम्स हैं प्लेयर्स के लिए कि अगर उसको क्लासिफिकेशन कराना पड़ता है तो नेशनल जब ऑर्गेनाइज होता है तो उससे दो दिन रिजर्व रखे जाते हैं क्लासिफिकेशन के लिए, तो उन दो दिनों में ही जो भी क्लासिफिकेशन नए प्लेयर को कराना होता है उन दो दिनों में उनको आना होता है.
So there is no pre-information या pre-evaluation नहीं होता जो.
No, 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 sir.
Pre-evaluation नहीं रहता sir.
I think Vijayji, this is a good input that you know everything has to be done in 2 days, starting from
assessment, yeah, yeah,
filling the forms, attending the committee, playing the game.
Yes.
Form के लिए एक month मिलता है उनको. जैसे हमारा national organize होता है, जैसे इस बार हमारा March में organize national, तो सभी को at least March के starting और February के end तक inform कर दिया जाता है कि इस date पे हमारा national organize होगा और ये दो दिन आपके classification के reserve होंगे. तो जो भी नए प्लेयर होते हैं 1 month के अंदर अपना प्रिपरेशन करके अपनी मेल के थ्रू उनको इन्फॉर्म करते हैं. इंटरनेशनल बॉडी जो हमारी अभी जो ऑर्गेनाइज करा रही हो पैरा टेबल टेनिस प्रमोशन एसोसिएशन जो इंदौर में है उसके जनरल सेक्रेटरी प्रमोद गंगराडे जी हैं. तो प्रमोद गंगराडे जी की ही मेल आईडी है, उनपे मेल वगैरह सब करते हैं और जितने भी नए प्लेयर आते हैं फिर वो क्लासिफायर को प्रोवाइड करा दिए जाते हैं कि इतने प्लेयरों ने अपने क्लासिफिकेशन के लिए इन्विटेशन या एप्लीकेशन दी है. तो फिर क्लासिफिकेशन उन दो दिन के अंदर उन नए प्लेयरों को क्लासिफिकेशन ऑर्गेनाइज कराते हैं.
Now, Hemant का एक इंटरेस्टिंग क्वेश्चन आया है कि कैन वी हैव ए पैरा स्टेट मैनेजर, दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन.
जो विजय अग्रवाल ने सर ने कहा था ना कि स्टेट में स्टेट वाइज हमारी बॉडी नॉर्मल बॉडी के साथ बन जाए, तो उसके लिए सबसे अच्छा वो यही है कि अगर एक प्लेयर 1 या 2 पर्सन ऐसे हो जिनको स्पेशली उसके लिए रखा जाए कि आप पैरा के लिए देखिए आपके स्टेट में कौन कौन से प्लेयर हैं जो आपके इवेंट में खेल सकते हैं. तो अगर ऐसा हो जाएगा तो वो बहुत सारी प्रॉब्लम हमारी सोल्ड आउट हो जाएंगी.
तो मेरा कहना ये है कि जो सब बात कर रहे हैं कि हमें पूरे साल बच्चों को मतलब जो भी प्लेयर्स हैं उनके पास इंफॉर्मेशन नहीं होती है कि कब ये क्लासिफिकेशन होना होने वाला है या नेशनल्स होने वाले हैं. सो दैट एक ऐसा कोई भी एक मैनेजर या फिर कोई भी एक ऐसा पर्टिकुलर ऑफिशियल अगर हम उस बॉडी में से जो एसोसिएशन है उसमें से किसी को अगर ड्यूटी दे दें कि हाँ जिसको भी कनेक्ट करना है उसके पास उन सब का डेटा हो एंड जब भी हमारे पास नेशनल की या क्लासिफिकेशन की जैसी नोटिफिकेशन आए वो बी दो लोग दो प्लेयर्स या 10 प्लेयर्स फ्रॉम द स्टेट वो उनके पास इंफॉर्मेशन भेज दें.
जो प्रमोद जी हैं जो प्रमोद कांडे जो इंदौर वाले अगर उनकी कॉन्टेक्ट इन्फॉर्मेशन हम आपस में शेयर कर लें देन आई थिंक
सर प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व होने वाली नहीं है उससे.
नहीं मेन प्रॉब्लम सर वो स्टेट वाइज वाली है. प्रमोद जी तो है बाकी जैसे आईटीटीएफ के अंडर हम लोग आते हैं जो टेबल टेनिस फेडरेशन है वही हम लोगों का देख रही है. लेकिन जैसे टेबल टेनिस फेडरेशन की स्टेट में हर स्टेट में अपनी बॉडी है तो करना क्या चाहिए टीटीएफआई को अपनी हर स्टेट बॉडी को एक लेटर लिखना चाहिए एक इन्फॉर्मेशन देनी चाहिए कि अभी जो पैरा टेबल टेनिस को देख रही है वो पैरा टीटीए प्रमोद गंगराडी जी देख रहे हैं और इसी तरह उन्होंने हर स्टेट में 1 या 2 पर्सन को जो नॉर्मल बॉडी एसोसिएशन है उसमें ही 1-2 पर्सन को नॉमिनेट करना चाहिए कि आप पैरा टीटी देखिए और आपके ही हमारे नेशनल में एंट्री जाएगी.
Correct.
तो अगर वो लोग हमारी एंट्री नेशनल में भेज लेंगे तो हमारी सारी प्रॉब्लम सोल्व आउट हो जाएगी.
Yes. और टूर्नामेंट में रेगुलराइजेशन भी हो जाएगा.
एग्जैक्टली सर सेग्रीगेट हो जाएगा काम तो मे बी थोड़ा सा और हो सके.
बिल्कुल
अजय सर मैं ये भी बात बोलना चाहता हूँ कि ये बार जो नेशनल्स हुए उस वक्त पैरा एमपीटीटी वालों ने महाराष्ट्र स्टेट के कुछ लोगों को स्पेशली वहां पे बुलाया था कि ये गेम देखो ये आप जान लो पैरा क्या है क्या नहीं है और आप इसे फिर ऑर्गेनाइज करने की कोशिश करो.
जो कोचिस थे वो भी इंटरनेशनल क्लासिफाइड जो हमारे एम्पायर बने क्योंकि इस बार क्या था कि रेगुलर वहां पर कॉम्पिटिशन चल रहे थे. पहले वहां पर जूनियर का हुआ है इंदौर में ही उसके बाद मतलब उससे जूनियर सीनियर दोनों ही वहां पर थे सब कैडेट वाला कैडेट और जूनियर और उसके बाद फिर हमारा इवेंट था पैरा वाला. तो उसके लिए रेगुलर इवेंट चल रहे थे और जो इंटरनेशनल क्लासिफाइड प्लेयर्स हैं मतलब कोचिज हैं वही हमारे लिए एम्पायरिंग के लिए भी थी. तो उन लोगों ने इस बार बहुत सारे इंटरेस्ट भी लिया. जैसे नॉर्मल उनको सर्विसिंग में बहुत डिफिकल्टी आती है क्योंकि हमारी जो मेन डिफरेंस आता है नॉर्मल और व्हीलचेयर कैटेगरी में जब हम सर्विस करते हैं तो उसमें थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है बाकी सारा स्पोर्ट सेम्स होता है. तो उन लोगों ने उसके बारे में भी बहुत नॉलेज लिया हम लोगों से तो वो भी इंटरेस्ट ले रहे थे उस चीज को. यही है कि अगर हम ऐसे ही ऑर्गेनाइज कराएं इवेंट्स तो लोग ज्यादा से ज्यादा जुड़ेंगे और ज्यादा से ज्यादा इंटरेस्ट लेंगे क्योंकि जब कम्युनिकेशन होता है तभी क्वेश्चन आते हैं और कभी तभी सॉल्यूशन होता है. कम्युनिकेशन ही नहीं होगा तो आगे नहीं बढ़ेगी.
मेन बात यही है सर कि टीटीएफआई ने उनके उनके स्टेट के बॉडी ने पैरा के लिए एक बॉडी बनानी चाहिए जिसमें पैरा प्लेयर भी हो, तो ये सब प्रॉब्लम सॉल्व हो जाते हैं।
आई बिलीव वी वर जॉइंड विद विनायक सूतर, बट वो भी शायद चले
क्लासिफायर फ्रॉम कोल्हापुर।
राइट तो कैन वी कंक्लूड दिस सेशन टुडे और एनीवन वांट्स टू से समथिंग, कोई कुछ कहना चाहे, कोई मैसेज? त्रिवेंद्र आप ट्राई करो विराट कोहली फाउंडेशन के लिए अगर पॉसिबल है तो।
नहीं सर, मैं चाहूंगा कि हमारी जो अभी एसोसिएशन है उसके एक ग्रुप, अगर जैसे हमारा नेशनल पे प्राइज होता है तो अभी हमें साई के ऊपर डिपेंड रहना पड़ता है अपने नेशनल ऑर्गेनाइज कराने के लिए भी, क्योंकि साई अगर फंड करेगा रिलीज तभी हमारा वो नेशनल ऑर्गेनाइज होगा। बाय चांस अगर किसी वजह से अगर ऐसा ना हो पाए, साई फंड दे, तो हमारा नेशनल पे ऑर्गेनाइज नहीं हो पाएगा।
दैट इज ओके, जो जो वो कर रहे हैं वो तो कर ही रहे हैं, दैट इज ओके, दीज थिंग्स आर गोइंग पैरेलल, बट अगर हम अपने लेवल पे भी उनको लिखें, एफर्ट करें, सो आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनी हार्म, क्योंकि स्वास्तिका घोष को भी तो मतलब उसके फादर ने या उसने हेल्प की है ना इसके लिए जो।
या ओके बेलमैन,
या और कोई? यस ये तो जो जो विजय जी कर रहे हैं वो तो दैट इज ओके, वो तो कर ही रहे हैं वो तो जो है ना, सो आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनी हार्म इन ट्राइंग एटलीस्ट। और कोई कुछ? प्रोबेबली
हर स्टेट में हर इसमें बॉडी बननी चाहिए सर, बस।
आई थिंक संजय सर जो आप बोल रहे हो बॉडी बननी चाहिए, बॉडी अभी एकदम फर्स्ट स्टेज पे तो कोई भी आई डोंट थिंक सो इतनी जल्दी अग्री करेगा, बट मे बी वही जो बॉडी हमारी ऑलरेडी है उसी में शायद एक सेक्शन वो लोग अगर हमें पैरा को दे दे दैट विल आल्सो हेल्प।
क्या
एंड द पैरा स्टेट मैनेजर जो स्टेट पैरा स्टेट
सेट होना चाहिए
सर। नॉर्मल जो है उनके पास पावर है पैरा की भी, तो वो अपनी पावर भी शेयर नहीं करेंगे।
बट सर जो पैरा की पावर है वो संजय जी ने फर्स्ट वीडियो में हमें दिखाई थी, अगर आप वो देखेंगे तो दैट इज अ रियल पावर, दैट इज पैरा।
अभी बेंगलोर कर्नाटका वाले जो है वो अच्छा काम कर रहे सर इसमें पैरा में, जब जैसे मैंने अभी बताया, दिनेश सर ने अभी, संजीव हजारी ने भी बताया कि उनका उनका स्टेट का बॉडी वो अच्छा बना रहे हैं और उसके तरफ से उन्होंने ये बार नेशनल ये भी लिया, स्टेट लेवल उनका लिया है।
इफ दे शेयर विद अस, इफ दे शेयर विद अस देन वी कैन लर्न फ्रॉम देम, उनसे सीख सकते हैं। राइट,
या
सो लोकेश अभी इज इट ओके और यू वांट टू से सम, कैन वी कंक्लूड द
सर? मैं आप सभी को थैंक यू बोलना चाहता हूं क्योंकि लास्ट डिस्कशन में आप लोगों को पैरा के बारे में कुछ भी मालूम नहीं था, मगर आप लोगों ने उसमें इंटरेस्ट लिया और हम लोगों को गैदर किया और हमें क्लासिफायर के बारे में बात करने का मौका दिया, और ये भी अच्छा लगा कि आप लोग पैरा में इंटरेस्टेड हैं।
आप भी हम में से एक हैं, सो आई डोंट सी एनी डिफरेंस, बिकॉज जैसे आप खेलते हैं वैसे ही हम खेलते हैं।
बिल्कुल सर, जैसे आईटीटीएफ का स्लोगन है कि वन स्पोर्ट्स वन फैमिली, तो वही एक चीज होनी चाहिए कि वन स्पोर्ट्स है वन फैमिली होनी चाहिए, ये नहीं कि नॉर्मल बॉडी टेबल टेनिस खेल लिए तो अलग और हम लोग खेल रहे हैं तो वो अलग।
बट मैं सिर्फ एक विजय जी को एक ही बात कहना चाहता हूँ कि जैसे इन्होंने बताया था कि कुछ फ्रॉड ऑर्गेनाइजेशन है जो फंड का मिस यूज करते हैं, तो मैं सिर्फ एक ही बात कहना चाहता हूँ कि जब 5000 किलोमीटर दूर बैठे आईटीटीएफ ने हमें रिकॉग्नाइज कर लिया, चाहे वो पिंग पोंग हो या PSIUS हो, तो इन माय ओपिनियन, हाँ यस यस बीकन थापा, वो 4-5 साल से रेगुलर आईटीटीएफ के साथ जुड़े हुए हैं, सो आई थिंक प्लेयर शुड हैव फुल फेथ एंड ट्रस्ट दैट व्हाटएवर वी डू विल बी इन द बेस्ट इंटरेस्ट ऑफ द प्लेयर्स एंड सोसाइटी।
या
राइट, सो लोकेश कुछ आप कहना चाहते हैं?
ओके सर, सो वी जस्ट गोइंग टू कंक्लूड विद आवर सेशन। Firstly, it is a lovely session to talk with the delivery of the speech given by Michael sir and Sanjay sir, and both of them cover all the basic topics of para table tennis. It is a very good opportunity for all of us, being me as a host and for all of us as a spectator or a participant.
Yeah, and I will give my liaison assignment to Vijay Kumar Agarwal ji, because there is another project we have started, outdoor concrete table. So Vijay ji, I need your phone number because this is a very big topic. In Delhi only 255 parks are there in Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
So if we put, for example, two or three, you know, sample tables in each, just it is for only for beginner. It is only for fun play. It is not, yeah, not for professional player. No, only just to player to take the feel. So that assignment we want to, you know, discuss with you, that one.
No, you can anytime.
Yeah, please share your phone number or email address.
I will.
Yeah, I have already given.
I have already given
to Lokesh.
Okay.
Yeah.
We will share.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you, Trivendra. Thank you, Prerma. Thank you. Ravindra.
Thank you, all the participants.
Datta Prasad.
And organizers.
Shafiq.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Bhavika. Okay. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye, sir.
Poonam Rani
thank
from
you,
Chandigarh.
Rose City. What is the city name?
Pardon?
They have a city Chandigarh. Name. The city beautiful. Chandigarh.
Yeah, city is beautiful. And abhi do din se sir waah khub barish ho rahi hai.
There is a name on the gate. There is a written name.
Chandigarh.
Chandigarh, beautiful, some wording is written.
City beautiful. Yeah.
Right. Okay, thank you. Right. Thank you.
Okay, sir.
Thank you. 1, 2, 3.